Daniel Nicholas Flavin Jr. was born on April 1, 1933 in Jamaica, New York. He was born into an Irish Catholic family and had a twin brother named David. His parents were Daniel Flavin Sr. and Viola Bernzot. Daniel Sr. wanted his son to be a priest. Dan and David went to the Immaculate Conception Preparatory Seminary in Brooklyn in 1947.
They graduated in 1952.
In 1953, he married his first wife, Sandra Severdija, an art student at the New York University. Soon after that, Dan joined his brother David in the Air Force. During military service from 1954 to 1955, Dan went to school at the University of Maryland in Korea. When he returned to New York in 1956, Dan briefly attended the Hans Hofmann School of Fine Arts and studied art with Albert Urban. As a studio artist, he was mostly self-taught.
His first works were abstract impressionism paintings. Then, in 1961, Dan had his first solo art show in the Judson Gallery. In the summer of 1961, Dan was working as a night guard for the Museum of Natural History. He was staring up at the light fixtures all the time, and that's what really gave him the idea to work with lights. David, Dan's twin, died in 1962. Flavin married his second wife, Tracy Harris, in a ceremony at the Guggenheim Museum in 1962 also. In 1963, he finally got rid of the canvas and started working with fluorescent lights. In 1966, Dan filled an entire gallery with a light installation. Finally, from the 1970s to the 1980s, he did his more complicated works like the bar
corridors.
Dan is best known for his minimalist works, such as the barred quarters. He also did a few works of art that were inspired by other artists' works, like Untitled, to Henri Matisse. He also made art like that to Vladimir Tatlin, Piet Mondrian, and John Gris. My favorite by Dan is Broken Full Circle. I like this piece because it reminds me of a rainbow. The background is black, but the colors pop so brightly, and I think it looks really cool with the broken black stuff on the ground. I also like Untitled, to Veronica. I like this one because it is so layered, and you can really see the light on the walls. Dan Flavin died in Riverhead, New York, of diabetes. A memorial for him was held at the Diaz Center for Arts on January 23, 1997.